Any doubt till now? We have discussed sixth question. Sixth question we have discussed one way in one way of the solution. Was that we have taken the we have formed the quadratic equation. That was the one way. That was the first method. We have used second method. We could have solved using expansion. Okay, are you familiar with the expansions? Sixth question. Okay, sixth question. Let's discuss it again. So we were having the equation x minus y equal to 4 and 1 upon y minus 1 upon x, and it was 4 upon 21. 4 upon 21. These were the two equations we have solved. Okay. So one way was forming the quadratic equation, that is y x equal to y minus 4 or y equal to x plus 4. Y equal to x plus 4 we have put, and a quadratic equation was formed, and then middle term split, and we have got the solution for x2, x minus 3 and x plus 3, I think. X plus 3 and x minus 7 equal to 0. This way we have factorized the equation and later. So the solutions are x plus 3 equal to 0 or x minus 7 equal to 0. So x cannot be negative. X has to be positive because x and y are positive number. It is given equation. Therefore, x minus 7 equal to 0, so x equal to 7. That was the solution. Okay, by quadratic equation. Okay. Now how to solve by expansions. Okay, we have done in expansion. If you remember, x plus y the whole square. It is how much? X square plus y square plus 2xy. This identity you all remember. The other expansion, x minus y the whole square. X square plus y square minus 2xy. Okay, these two identities we have already studied. Okay, so using these two identities as well, we can solve this equation. These two simultaneous equations, okay? So if we take the second equation, okay? What we are going to get if we take the LCM? X minus y upon xy equal to 4 upon 21 we have got, okay? What is the value of x minus y? It is 4 from the first equation. We put here 4 upon xy equal to 4 upon 21. It means xy equal to 21. So value of xy is 21. This you all have studied, value of xy equal to 21. Okay. Now x minus y we have 4. What we require? X plus y equal to something. This we require. If we get the value of x plus y, we can solve these two equations afterwards. X minus y we already have. If we get the value of x plus y equal to something, we can solve these two equations afterwards. Okay, to get the value of this, what we require? X plus y equal to x square plus y square plus 2xy. Okay, its value we require and its value we require. Its value we already have, xy equal to 21 from the second equation, and first equation we have solved a little bit. Okay, its value we have, its value we require. Okay, now see the second equation. X minus y we already have 4, xy we have 21. We can get the value of x square plus y square from this equation. Yes or no? X minus y, this square, okay? X minus y the whole square equal to x square plus y square minus 2xy, okay? Put the value of x minus y, 4 square, x square plus y square minus 2 into 21, 42, okay? 16 equal to x square plus y square minus 42. X square plus y square equal to 16 plus 42 is 58. You got the value of x square plus y square? Okay. Now its value we have to get. So it's 58, it's 21. You can get the value of x plus y square from there. 58 plus 42. How much it is? 100. Okay, if we take the root, x plus y equal to root of 100, it is plus minus 10. Okay, since it is given x and y both are positive numbers, it means their sum will be always positive. So x plus y equal to 10 we have to take. Okay, have you understood this one? So what we are doing is x minus y we already have, xy we have calculated. Okay, what we require, x plus y if we get, we can solve x and y. Okay, so these two equations using these two equations. Okay, so x plus y the whole square is this much, xy we already have, this quantity we don't have. So this we have calculated from this second equation, this one. X minus y the whole square, we can calculate from here, 16. X square plus y square, we have to calculate, xy we already have. Its value we calculate and put it here, and we get the value of x plus y, okay? Now you have got the two equations, okay? Using these two equations, solve the value of x and y. You can solve the value of x and y, okay? Solve it. Okay, this was the second method. First method we already discussed yesterday by forming the quadratic equation and middle term split. And then we got two solutions and we satisfy the question. We have got one solution. And this is using expansions. Okay, these two identities we have used. This is clear or not? Is it clear to all? Have you understood this one? We have done many questions like this. In rational numbers as well, we have done. In expansions as well, these questions we have done. Is this clear? Okay, then go for seventh question.
Yes, sir.
Okay, go for seventh question. Read seventh question, try to form the equation. I'll start after a minute. First, you try. Read the question properly, try to form the equations. Okay. Okay, then we'll see how these equations are to be formed. Read it and try to form. Okay, and keep doing it for your notebook. If you make mistake, just cross with a line. Okay, and don't use whitener. Okay, form the equation, write them. Okay, first read the equation properly. Two numbers are in the ratio 4:5, okay? We're having two numbers in the ratio 4:5. If 30 is subtracted from each of the number, from both we are subtracting 30, the ratio becomes 1:2, okay? It's easy, find the numbers. We have to find the numbers. So let the two numbers be x and y, okay? So first line, let the two numbers B, X and Y. We got the two numbers. Okay. Now the ratio is 4:5. So the ratio is 4:5. Okay. If 30 is subtracted from each of the numbers, 30 subtracted means it is subtracted from X, it is subtracted from Y. So numbers X minus 30 and second will be y minus 30. Now their ratio becomes 1:2, okay? Now their ratio will become 1:2. X minus 30 divided by y minus 30, it will become 1/2, okay? Okay, now what you're going to do, cross multiply. Cross multiply, okay? It is how much? 5x equal to 5y. And here, 2x minus 30.
So it is 4y.
Oh yeah, yes, it is 4y, okay? Thank you, it's 4y, okay? 2x minus 30 equal to y minus 30, okay? Now solve them further, solve it further. And then accordingly, we see in which form we require, do we require this equation, okay? I'll left some space here as well, okay? So it is 2x minus 60 equal to y minus 30. Y we take on that side, 2x minus y equal to 60 minus 30 30. Okay. Or if you want to use the, by quitting the coefficients, you want to solve 5x minus 4y equal to 0. Okay. So this equation and this equation. Okay. Solve them. Okay. If you are equating the coefficients, then multiply this equation by 4. Okay. If you are equating the coefficient, multiply this equation by 4 and solve. Everyone solve it. You both have, you all have got the equation. Most important part in this question is that we must, how we are able to form the equations. Okay. How we are able to form the equations. To form the equations is the most important part. Rest is just as you have solved in other questions, earlier the exercises. Okay, solve everyone. Find the value of x and y. Find the value of x and y. Okay. If you're writing first this or this, or first you can write this one, then this one, it's no issue. We have to multiply this with 4. So it will be 8x minus 4y equal to 120. Okay. This equation is 5x minus 4y equal to 0. Okay. You can write this equation first, this equation second, doesn't matter. Okay. Now,
so that's value 40.
Okay, 40 it is now, yes, 340 it will come. It is 3x, it is 0 equal to 120, x equal to 40, x equal to 40. Find the value of y either from here or here, either from here, any of these you can use to calculate the value of y. Calculate the value of y, x we have got
50. 40.
Okay,
50.
It will be 50, okay. 5 into 40 equal to 4 into y. Y equal to 5 into 40 divided by 4. It is 50. At last, you have to write what's the question asking. Find the numbers. The numbers are 40 and 50. The numbers are 40 and 50. You can see now 40 divided by 50, 4 by 5. 40 minus 30, 10. 50 minus 30, 20. 10 by 20, 1 by 2. We have solved correctly. You can check as well. You can check as well. Okay. Yes, everyone try 8 questions. I'll start after a minute. Okay. Try to form the equations. Read it properly. First, read the question whole. What we have to find? We have to find the fraction. If the numerator of a fraction is increased by this and denominator is decreased by 1, it becomes this. If the numerator is increased by 1 and denominator is increased by 2, it becomes 1 by 3. Find the fraction. So take any fraction. Take fraction as x by y. Okay. Let the fraction be x by y. Now form the equation, everyone. Okay. Let fraction be x and x by y. Okay. Suppose that one. So let. You can suppose anything like a by b, p by q, m by n. That's up to you. But let's suppose it x by y, so that it will be same for all. Let fraction be x by y. Okay. Now solve it. Now form the equations first. Everyone form the equations. Everyone form the equation. Form the equations. Yeah.
Sir, first equation 3x minus 2y is equals to minus 10. Sir, you are on mute.
Okay, I muted myself. I was coughing, so I muted and I forgot 1 minute. Okay, sorry. If the numerator of a fraction is increased by 2, read the equation properly. If the numerator of a fraction is increased by 2, okay, numerator is x. We are increasing x by 2. We have increased. Pay attention, these are very important. If the numerator of a fraction is increased by 2, and denominator is decreased by 1. Denominator we are decreasing by 1. It will be y minus 1. Okay. The fraction becomes, it becomes 2 by 3. So y minus 1. Now this fraction will become 2 by 3. Become means equal to 2 by 3. Understood? Numerator increased by 2 and denominator decreased by 1. The fraction becomes 2 by 3. This is clear? First equation. Okay. Second one. If the numerator is increased by 1, if the numerator is increased by 1 and denominator is increased by 2, is increased by 2 plus 2, it becomes 1 by 2. You have got the two equations. Now cross multiply. Okay. Cross multiply 3x plus 2. Equal to 2y minus 1. Okay, this equation will write for.
Sir, it is 1 by 3. Second equation. In second equation.
Second equation, 1 by 3 it is. It becomes 1 by 3. It's become 1 by 3. Yes. It becomes 1 by 3. Okay. So all these equations. So we have 3x plus 6 equal to 2y minus 2. 2y we take on that side, 3x minus 2y equal to minus 8. Okay. Solve the second equation. 3x plus 1 equal to y plus 2. 3x plus 3. Equal to y plus 2. So second equation I'm writing here. Okay, second equation will be 3x minus y equal to minus 1. Okay, have you all got the same kind of equation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is our first equation and its second equation. Okay, now solve them. Everyone solve them. Now onwards, I won't be solving the equations, okay? You all have to solve and tell me the answers.
Sir, x is 2 and y is 7.
X is 2.
2.
Okay. X we are getting 2 and y equal to 7.
Yes, sir.
7. Okay. Everyone solve the equation, okay? And what the question is asking?
Fraction.
Find the fraction. So we have to express it in fraction. The fraction is 2 by 7. Fraction
two
is
by
2 by 7. At last we will write. The fraction is 2 by 7. Okay, everyone calculate. Solve the equations. Solve the equations. 3x minus 2y equal to minus 8. 3x minus y equal to minus 1. Okay. So we can separate first. We can separate second from first very easily. X coefficients are same. You get the value of y first. You can get the value of x then. Okay. It's up to you whether you calculate y first or x first. Okay. Everyone solve the equation. Solved. Okay. So answer you are getting this one. The fraction is 2 by 7. The fraction is 2 by 7. You have to write down, sir. Okay. Everyone have completed eighth question. Okay. Now go for ninth. first from the expressions, whatever from the equations, what we are getting. And keep solving along in the class. Let's see again fraction or not. Find the fraction, okay? So again, let the fraction be x by y. Okay, we have to find the fraction. Okay, the sum of the numerator and the denominator of a fraction is equal to 7. Sum of the numerator plus denominator is 7. It is given. Sum of the numerator and denominator of a fraction is equal to 7. It means this equation, are you getting all? Okay. Now 4 times the numerator will be 4x. Okay. 4 times the numerator is 8, less than 5 times the denominator. Okay. 5 times the denominator. Okay. This is how much less? 8 less than this. 8 less than this. Have you understood? Read the statement again. 4 times the numerator is 8 less than 5 times the denominator. Okay. Is 8 less than 5 times the denominator. It means 5y minus 4y will minus 4x will be 4X. How much? How much it will be?
8.
It is 8. You can see. This is how much less? It is 8 less than this one. Or we can write 4x plus 8 equal to 5y. Okay. If we add 8 into 4x, it will become equal to 5y. Okay. 4x plus 8 equal to 5y. You can write in either form. Both are the same form, same equation. Okay. Read the question again. 4 times the numerator is 8 less than 5 times the denominator. This one, this quantity is how much less as compared to this one? It is 8 less. It means if we subtract 5y minus 4x, if we subtract 4x from 5y minus 4x, we are getting 8. This, you all have understood? You all have understood? This is important, very important. These kind of questions will be more and more. Okay. So 4 times the numerator is 8 less than 5y. So from 5y, we subtract 4x, we are going to get 8. Okay. This is clear. Okay. You have got both the equations, solve them. Either make the coefficients of x. Okay. We can write it again. Minus 4x plus 5y equal to 8. Either you can solve in this form, or you want to take them 4x minus 5y equal to minus 8 as well, you can write. Okay, that's up to you. Solve these two equations. Solve the equations and find the value of x and y. Solve the equations. Find the value of x and y.
For x is 3 and y is 4.
Okay, solve, everyone solve. Everyone solve the equation. After 1 minute, we'll start the next question. Okay. Solve the equation. And write the answer in the form the question is asking. What the question is asking? The fraction. So we'll write the answer in fraction. Okay. Write it in fraction. So the fraction is 3 by 4. The fraction is 3 by 4. Okay. Everyone is able to solve the equation. Anyone have doubt, do ask. Okay. If you face the doubt, do ask. Or else you are going to suffer. Okay. So better ask. And don't care about others, what others will think. If you have doubt,
sir, ask. I'm,
I think the answer is x value.
Okay, x value you are getting now. Okay, anyone else? If you face the doubt, ask immediately. Okay, don't care about others, what others will think. Always ask the doubt, okay? Okay, now we are going to solve this one, okay? So the equations are, okay, x plus y equal to 7. Second equation, minus 4x plus 5y equal to 8, okay? So I'm making, we are making y as same, okay? So by 5, we have to multiply first one, 5x plus 5y equal to 35, okay? Minus 4x plus 5y equal to 8. So we are subtracting them, it will become plus, minus, minus. Okay, 5x plus 4x, how much we are getting? 9x, this is clear? 5x plus 4x, 5y minus 5y, 0, no need of writing. 35 minus 8, how much it will be? 20, how much? 27, is this clear? Okay, calculate x equal to 27 upon 9 equal to 3. Calculate y now, put x equal to 3 in that equation. Y equal to 7 minus 3, that is how much? So putting x equal to 3 in x plus y equal to 7. It is 3 plus y equal to 7. Y equal to 7 minus 3, that is 4. Okay, so the answer is, the fraction is 3 by 4, 3 upon 4. Understood now? Now check where you have made the mistake. So always ask the doubt. In my class, there used to be one girl and she always asked the doubt. Sometimes in a minute, she used to ask three or four doubts. So whenever any doubter I see, immediately ask. Okay. Even many students used to laugh at her, but later on what happened? She got the highest marks in class. And afterwards, no one laughed. So this is how everyone should be. Okay, whatever mistake you make, never be afraid of them. Never be ashamed of them as well, okay? All we have to learn is that we should never make the mistakes again, okay? But if you have got the doubt, do ask. Every time do ask. Okay, this is clear. Have you understood? Okay, do the next one. In life, always speak up. Okay. Okay, do the next one. As well, you all know, when you don't ask the doubt, you always face the trouble. The doubt creates more doubts. Those more doubts will create more and more doubts. And the process will continue. So while you grow in life, you will have the burden of doubts only. Yes or no? So always ask the doubts and get them cleared. Okay? 10th one. And this should not be over your mind that should I ask or not? Okay? Always should be, we must ask, okay? 10th one, do the 10th question. Everyone start doing the 10th one. I'll do afterwards. After a minute, I'll start. Do the 10th one. Start doing the 10th one. Okay. You all have read the questions. Read it properly, okay? Half of the problem is solved when we read the question properly. That is, in life as well, half of the problem is solved when we understand the problem, what the problem is. To solve something, we must know what it is first. So first try to understand what it is, then try to solve. Okay, if the number of a fraction, numerator of a fraction is multiplied by 2 and denominator is increased by 1, it becomes 1. However, if the numerator is increased by 4 and denominator is multiplied by 2, the fraction becomes half. Find the fraction. So let the fraction be x by y. Okay, we have read once. Now read it properly. Let the fraction be x by y. Okay. If the numerator of a fraction is multiplied by 2, we have to multiply the numerator by 2. It will be 2x. And its denominator is increased by 1, the fraction becomes 1. Denominator is increased by 1. Increased by 1 means, and this fraction becomes 1. This equation you'll get. Okay. Now the second statement. However, if the numerator is increased by 4, increased by 4 means the numerator is increased by 4. And denominator is multiplied by 2. Denominator is multiplied by 2. That is y into 2 or 2y we can write. The fraction becomes, becomes half. It becomes half. Okay, cross multiply them. So here 2x equal to y plus 1. You all have got the equations? See here. When we have got the equation, half of the problem is solved. Now, just like other problems we have solved, we have to solve this one. Same applies with life. We understand the problem, what the problem is. Then we already have experiences of solving many problems. Using those experiences, we can solve the present problem. Yes or no? That like in this instant, I have done like this. So if I do like this, I may succeed. Okay. So solve them now. 2x minus y equal to 1. 2x minus y equal to 1. This is our first equation. Okay. Cross multiply the second one and form the equation. 2 into, and don't miss the steps. Always write the steps. It is 2y, 2x plus 8 equal to 2y. 2x minus 2y equal to minus 8. Okay, check whether I have formed the equation correct or not. Everyone check yours. Okay, can you do something here? See a common is there? Can we simplify the equation further? Yes or no? Take 2 outside,
yes,
x minus y equal to minus 4. Now see here, this equation is more easy to solve. So today we have learned that whenever there is common factor, we must remove. So that it is